des données incomplète. Voilà les mots d'Anthony Fauci, principal expert américain en maladies infectieuses. D'autres scientifiques de Washington ont donc suivi le mouvement. L'Institut national des allergies et des maladies infectieuses aux États-Unis publie aussi une déclaration. Selon eux, les données sur la dernière étude du vaccin AstraZeneca sont obsolètes. Je vous le rappelle, le groupe pharmaceutique suédo-britannique a annoncé hier que leur produit était efficace à 79% et qu'il n'y avait pas de risque de thrombose. US health officials raise concerns over AstraZeneca use.
Hey David, this is pretty unusual statement coming out from the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases just really later in the same day that we got those results from the phase 3 trial in the US of the AstraZeneca vaccine. The National Institutes of Allergy and Infectious Diseases saying that the Data Safety Monitoring Board, that's the oversight board seeing these trials, expressed concern that AstraZeneca may have included outdated information from that trial, which may have provided an incomplete view of the efficacy data. Now, we don't have more details than this. They said that they encouraged the company to work with the Data Safety Monitoring Board to update that information. AstraZeneca, you know, saying essentially that they had the interim cutoff of the data that they presented yesterday, February 17th. They're going to work with this board to share the primary analysis of the most up-to-date data, and they intend to issue those within 48 hours. So within 2 days, we should see essentially what led to this situation, guys. But it's very unusual that, you know, a national body would need to come out and make a statement like this rather than sort of work with the company behind the scenes to make sure that the information was updated. A very important note is this pertains to the efficacy finding, which was 79% effective in preventing symptomatic COVID in this vaccine trial we saw yesterday with these two doses of the AstraZeneca vaccine. There is nothing in here about the safety of this vaccine, which is very important. Of course, there were concerns in Europe over blood clot risk. They said they looked at that very closely and did not see that in this trial. AstraZeneca, you can see down there, the stock more than 3%. These are just the kinds of communication mishaps or mishandlings that just don't bode well for a vaccine in a public health program like this, guys. It's a real head scratcher. I've not seen something like this before. However, we've never been in a pandemic situation before where things are moving so quickly. But it's odd.
Et tout de suite, on retrouve Sybilla Oudjan for Key Figure.